Welcome back to stage 4 of this mini project. And in this stage, we're going to be doing what's shown on screen now. So we're going to connect to the on-premises server, and then from there, we're going to access AWS Server A to test the functionality of this site-to-site VPN connection. So let's go ahead and do that. So to do that, we need to move to the EC2 console. You should still have a tab open. If you don't, then you can open one in a new tab. Go to Instances Running, and we're going to be connecting to the on-premises server and using that to connect through to the AWS server. Now, I want you to imagine at this point that this is just a normal Windows machine on-premises. You're sat at this desk and you're using it to connect through the VPN connection to the AWS environment. In reality, we're going to be using SSM to connect in to this server as it's a private-only server. But just imagine you're sat at the desk and you're using it to connect into the AWS side infrastructure. So to connect to it, go ahead and select on-prem server, then right-click, go to connect, select RDP client, and we're going to connect to this instance using Fleet Manager, which is a feature of SSM, so that we can use the graphical user interface. So select connect using Fleet Manager. And we need to get the password for this Windows instance. Now to do that, click on Get Password, and you'll need to click on Browse and select the SSH key pair that you created and downloaded at the very start of this mini project. So go ahead and do that, and then click on Decrypt Password. So it's going to give you the password at the bottom as well as the username. Copy the password into your clipboard, make sure that you select Fleet Manager again, because in my case it changed, and then click on Fleet Manager Remote Desktop. We're going to be using user credentials, though we could use key pair, but we'll stick to user credentials. So enter administrator under username and paste in the password that you've got in your clipboard, and click on connect. This will take a few moments to connect. It's going to initially render a relatively small view, but if you click on the instance ID on this bar at the top, you'll get a full screen view. Now the quality is going to be relatively low, but this is only going to be used to illustrate the functionality of the VPN. If you get this option about networks, just click on yes. Now we're going to do two things to verify the VPN functionality. We're going to ping the AWS server and we're going to browse to it. So you're going to need the IP address of the AWS server. So move back to the EC2 console, go to Instances Running, select AWS Server A, copy its private IP into your clipboard, go back to the Windows desktop, click on the Windows button, type CMD for command, and then click to open the command prompt, and then type ping space, and then the IP address of AWS Server A, and press enter. And you should see a ping response. And this ping is going over the site-to-site VPN. So this indicates the VPN connection is working fine as expected. Next, we're going to verify the functionality of AWS Server A. So open Internet Explorer, then just click on OK. Maximize the screen to make it easy to see, and then type http://, and then the IP address of AWS Server A, and press enter. And if everything's working as expected, you should see a corporate-themed web application running within the AWS environment. And you can verify that by checking that this instance ID matches that of AWS Server A. So if we see it ends 99D3, and there we go, 99D3. So we can verify that this on-premises infrastructure is able to connect over the site-to-site VPN connection to the AWS environment. And at this point, congratulations, you've implemented the architecture that's shown on screen now. So this has been a relatively simple VPN demo. You've created a site-to-site VPN connection between AWS and a simulated on-premises environment. Now the steps you would use to do this in production would be much the same, but you might have a different on-premises VPN or firewall which you need to configure. The architecture is still the same, you'll be using multiple tunnels and you'll be configuring routes and security groups and potentially network ACLs. Now, I do have another advanced demo where I implement a much more complex dynamic BGP VPN. And in this mini project, you don't need to configure routing because BGP handles this automatically. But this has been a simple VPN mini project that's suitable for this level of study. Now, at this point, that's everything that you need to do in this mini project aside from clear up the environment. You need to return your account into the same state it was at the start of this mini project, but that's what you're going to do in the next stage of this mini project. At this point, that's everything you need to do in this video, so go ahead and complete the video, and when you're ready, I look forward to you joining me in the next and final video of this mini project.